Hi, and welcome to part two of this session. In this session, we'll be sharing about some of the goals of the Antichrist, as well as how the Antichrist will be working together with the false prophet and the 10 nation confederation at the end of the age. So I'll be sharing about four main goals and activities of the Antichrist, mainly found in Revelations 13, verse 5-7. It says, he was given a mouth speaking great things and blasphemies, and he was given authority to continue for 42 months. He opened his mouth in blasphemy against God, to blaspheme his name, his tabernacle, and those who dwell in heaven. It was granted to him to make war with the saints and overcome them, and authority was given him over every tribe, tongue, and nation. The first goal is where Antichrist will deceive the nations, many nations, into following him through his speech, where he'll be eloquent, impressive, and convincing. And he'll convince many nations, many world leaders in following him. He will be able to give demonically anointed messages that will be confirmed through demonic signs and wonders. And because of this, many will be moved by his speech and will follow him. Secondly, he will blaspheme God. The Antichrist is full of blasphemous names, and he shall speak blasphemies against the God of gods. He shall speak pompous words against the Most High, and he will accuse God of many things. In other words, things that have not been spoken by man before. You can just read Revelation 13 verse 1. He will accuse or blaspheme God in four things. Firstly, there will be blasphemy against God. Secondly, blasphemy of his name, blasphemy of his tabernacle, and blasphemy against those who dwell in heaven. His third main goal is where he will be given authority by God for 42 months, or 3.5 years. We can find this in Revelation 13 verse 7, Daniel 7 verse 22 and 25, and Daniel 8 verse 24. And this period will end with the second coming of Jesus. And his fourth main goal is where he will make war with the saints, and more than just making war with the saints, he will overcome them and many will be killed. You can find scriptures in the notes that we have attached below. One of the major agendas of the Antichrist is to persecute and kill the saints. Many will deny Jesus in the face of pressure and persecution and fear, while at the same time others will arise without fear and prevail in faith, being unafraid of death. The ultimate goal of the Antichrist can be found in Revelation 13 verse 4, which says, "So they worship the dragon who gave authority to the beast, and they worship the beast, saying, who is like the beast? Who is able to make war with him?" The ultimate goal of the Antichrist is to be worshipped by the nations. And many nations will follow and worship the Antichrist because of fascination, because of intimidation. And the term "who is like the beast" actually speaks of how there'll be worship from many nations and people because they are either awestruck or they're fascinated. At the same time, "who is able to make war with him?" It actually speaks of that non-resistance through intimidation. And to many, he will look invincible to unbelievers, and this is intimidating to the nations. Many will ask who can resist or who can make war against the Antichrist. And seemingly, the only way to survive, the only way to stay alive, is to serve the Antichrist. So I just want to give an overview of who the false prophet is. And this false prophet, he will have three primary strategies. Firstly, his goal is to seduce and deceive the nations to follow and to worship the Antichrist. Secondly, he will establish a worldwide worship movement by creating the image of the beast. This will be a counterfeit of the house of prayer movement that God is raising up in the last days. And third, he will create the Mark of the Beast economic system to finance the Antichrist worship movement. And he will oppress all those who resist the Antichrist and all who resist the Mark of the Beast. The false prophet will carry out five major activities. In Revelation 13 verse 11-12, it tells us of how the false prophet will move in demonically empowered public messages, and he will persuade and convince many to follow the Antichrist. Secondly, in Revelation 13 verse 13-14, it tells us of how the false prophet will do demonic miracles. This will be a counterfeit of God's promise of power in Joel 2 verse 28-32, where it talks about how God will pour out his spirit upon his church at the end of the age. Thirdly, in Revelation 13 verse 15, it speaks of worldwide economic oppression by the false prophet, where he will set up the economic system, to control the world's finance and trade. This will be done through the Mark of the Beast economic system. Fourth, he will establish a counterfeit worldwide worship movement where the false prophet will prophesy through demonic power as a counterfeit to the true end time prophetic movement. This can be found in Acts 2, verse 17 to 20, Malachi 4, verse 5, and Revelation 11, verse 3 to 6. His fifth major activity is where legislation will allow him to be unrestricted in his persecution, oppression, and murder of those who refuse to follow the Antichrist. So right now, I'll be moving on to the goal and agenda of the false prophet, as shown in Revelation 13, verse 12. Revelation 13, verse 12 says, "And he exercises all the authority of the first beast in his presence and causes the earth and those who dwell in it to worship the first beast, whose deadly wound was healed." Firstly, he exercises all the authority of the first beast in his presence. The false prophet will exercise the authority of the Antichrist. John emphasized three times that the false prophet will work miracles under the authority of the Antichrist. Secondly, he causes the earth and those who dwell in it to worship the first beast. The beast refers to the Antichrist. So the false prophet's primary goal and agenda is to raise up a worldwide worship movement in which Satan and the Antichrist are worshipped. Revelation 13 verse 4, 8, 12 and 15. So the false prophet, he will actually give accurate prophetic words. How do we discern between what is true and false and right and wrong? The primary issue is not the power of the gift, but in the fruit of the prophetic ministry. So there are three tests of the fruit. First, do they motivate people to love Jesus more? Do they inspire people to worship Jesus? And do they turn people towards obeying Him? So why would God allow these miracles? Why would God allow the false prophet to give accurate prophecies or even rain down fire from heaven and things like that? This is to test His people to see if they will love Him and obey God until the end. So next, I just want to give an overview and introduction of the 10 Nation Confederation in Revelation 17, verse 12 to 13. So Revelation 17, verse 12 to 13 actually describes the 10 Nation Confederation that will fully support the Antichrist. It has not arisen yet, but when it does, it will last for a short time. The 10 horns speak of a future 10 Nation Confederation that will rule simultaneously over their own nations as they come into an enthusiastic agreement or partnership under the Antichrist authority. You can find some of the verses in the notes. Revelation 17, verse 12 to 13 tells us of the emergence of this 10 Nation Confederation. The Antichrist will have a political, military, and economic alliance with this 10 Nation Confederation. And the identity of the 10 Nation Confederation can actually be found in the Bible, in Daniel 2, Daniel 7, and Ezekiel 38. And I'll just list them down here according to the names in the Bible. Firstly is Magog, Meshach, Tubal, Persia, Cush, Put, Gomer, Togarmah, Babylon, and Greco-Syria. And the ultimate goal of the 10 Nation Confederations together with the Antichrist and his empire is to actually go against Jesus, against his end-time church, and against Israel at the end of the age. So in the next few sessions, we'll be talking about some terms and events that will take place, like the Mark of the Beast, as well as the Abomination of Desolation. So God bless and see you.